This is a day trip that I did with Ian Schaefer up to Beaver Creek. We parked in the middle of the trail. We rode out to the east, then turned around and came back, rode all the way to the west, out to West Higgins Lake, and back to the car. We found a spot off of 7 Mile to park, kind of a nice spot, and then we took this little forest road up to look for the trail, and as usual, I couldn't find the trail. Finally, oh, there it is. So we found a little stop sign. We jump in here, and I am thinking, what in the hell? I was beginning to wonder if it was a mountain bike trail. After I talked to some others about riding this trail and conditions and what we saw, etc., I learned that this is a new section that was put in by John and Karen Bunker. It's called the Hero Section. Wonder why.
It opens up a little bit from that.
I put out these videos for a couple reasons. Number one, it's a way to document my rides so I can go back and relive them easily. And also so I can share them. And it's always nice to have some people enjoy them as well. The thing that I've always kind of wanted to do is to be able to relive the ride, most of it. So I tend to make my videos a little bit longer. The other thing that I've learned is that it takes forever to put these videos together. And when you're trying to boil it down to a very short video, it means you got to cut out so much. And it gets to be so difficult to try and keep it short. So, sorry if these things tend to get a little bit long. You can always skip ahead.
Wow.
This is actually pretty cool in here. I think they did a nice job setting this up. I'm sure once this thing gets ridden in a little bit, I'm sure it'll be really cool. Definitely slow you down. I don't think we'll see any whoops in this thing. It finally starts opening up a little bit. It really wasn't too long, but I was very confused when I first got in there and didn't expect it to be that tight. I didn't hear that Beaver Creek was so tight, and I'm wondering, what in the heck's going on? Of course, I have the perfect bike for it. You know, the KTM 500 XCW is designed and built for this exact purpose. No, honestly, I was really quite impressed with how this this bike went through this. It really wasn't that hard. I was just being very careful. That's kind of the way I ride. Thank you. You know, another reason why I like to keep these videos all complete, not chopped up too bad, is that if somebody wants to know what Beaver Creek is, what it's like to ride it, they can ride it. Almost the whole damn thing. I get to about here and I'm thinking, oh great, I can open it up a little bit. Not so fast. All right, that's enough. You get the idea.
I don't think that's the trail.
So we come out, and I'm looking at the sign, looking at Ian, going, wait a minute. Was that the trail? Or was that not the trail? Hadn't ridden this before, so I didn't know. And I figure, well, looks like this is the trail.
Yeah, this is more like it.
Okay, this section of trail got not that exciting. Sorry for the bouncy camera. It's my old GoPro. My new one is stabilized, but not this one. Anyway, yeah, this thing a little on the boring side. It did have some nice sections to it, but nothing like when we go back west. All right, that's enough of this. Let's skip ahead a little bit. At first, I thought that was a downed tree. We've run into a lot of downed trees this year. Here's a new band that I was introduced to through Pandora. It's called the Steel Drivers. Great stuff. The lead singer is Chris Stapleton. You may be familiar with him. I think he's won some Grammys or something. Awesome. Hope you like it.
Well, just look down, gave me 40 days. Instead of the fine that I could not pay. Said my prize will soon be home. Cross the line and you're on your own. 40 days. A shotgun. On the ground, work like hell till the sun goes down. 40 days, a shotgun and barbed wire fences. 40 nights to set a lesson. Midnight train to Memphis. Thank you.
are quite a few whoops. They're not terrible, but they're not great. Looks like there was some repair done there. Thank you, John Bunker. John and Karen. Followed the ribbon. This is smooth.
Needless to say, we stopped and removed that tree, and then we were on our way again. Man, this camera and the camera angle is kind of bugging me, so if you're getting bugged by a little bit, you're not alone. Anyway, that's my old, I think it was a Hero 3 Plus. I just got a new Hero 7 midway through the year. Wow, what a difference. So sorry about all the bouncing. Looking back at it, I'm almost thinking that it might not be bad to ride this again. It was actually pretty decent. I just wasn't sure where it was going, as usual, because there's a lot of vegetation. But I would definitely go ride this again. And wait till you see the west side. This is what I'm going to call the east side from where we parked. And then we went back and we rode the west side. The west side is phenomenal. This is a band I was turned on to back in the 80s. Peter Case. I think he only had one album, I don't know. It's pretty cool though, hope you enjoy it. Every man is not a king. Cry, cry, sing, sing. I've heard this before. We fight at the worst.
I ran over one, felt like it was getting fucked up.
Really mean.
There's a stop sign in the middle of freaking nowhere for nothing.
Oh, I remember this road. It was so sandy. had to get cruising before you had any stability at all.
Could be an arrow here. Here she comes. Here she comes. Walking down the street. Get the funniest looks from everyone we meet.
Yeah, I was singing. I was having a great time. This trail started opening up. Almost turned into like a Jeep trail. You can see it turning into a bit of a two-track. It was still pretty fun, but wasn't what I was expecting out of Beaver Creek. And that's because we went, I would say, the wrong direction. The west is definitely the better way to go.
Check the map just to be sure here in a minute.
After rewatching this, I remember I kept coughing. I had like this dry cough, and I'm going, oh my God, am I getting COVID? But it was actually turned out to be, as far as I could tell, it was kind of windy, if I remember right. And it was a little bit dusty, but mainly it was June, and the trees, all the pine trees, had pollen all over them. And you didn't really see it, but you could breathe it and you could feel it.
All right, I gotta check this map, make sure we're on the right route. Quad trail for a while. Yep. And then after we crossed the road,
We started
back where the target is, there.
Oh, okay.
So we're gonna go over to, basically to here,
and then hit a road.
And then turn around.
In case you're wondering what app that is, it's called Avenza, yeah. A-V-E-N-Z-A, Avenza Maps. And it's awesome because you can load in a PDF of the trail,
we were gonna park right there.
Like from the DNR,
we ended up parking about there.
And it will follow you on the map.
So we got in about,
don't know how the hell it does it, but it does it. It's pretty cool.
Ready?
This trail was actually pretty fun. It was nothing challenging, just a nice cruise. You get some speed up in some sections. Nothing too tricky. A little bit of sand, that's about it. But it did get boring.
Logging ahead, awesome.
I am constantly blowing turns like this. Every time there's like a cut in from a road section like this or whatever, I swear I always pass it. Especially when it's a long way like that, you don't expect it coming. This was a really cool section through here. It was pretty. The trail's not beat up. Just a little bit of debris here and there. I was thinking about clearing that, but I'm like, that looks like too much work. I'll just go around it. We'll leave that for John and Karen. Thanks, John, Karen, appreciate it. The 500 is great on these trails. You just put it in whatever third, something like that, and just roll through it a little above idle. Helps on the gas mileage. We're coming up to the end. There's a road that we come to, and we stop there. Oh, another one of my favorite sections, logging. Oh, don't worry, it'll grow back. Yeah, not in my lifetime. It's funny, this thing started opening up and I just kind of kept going faster and faster and faster. It was fun. I like this trail. I definitely want to go back and ride it again. But if I go start in the middle, I'm probably not going to go east again. We're coming up to the end here. I'm gonna make this the end of part one. Look for you on part two.
Drinking dog whiskey, telling my life.